Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. Hey, let's just get started and jump right into it. Yesterday, we talked about car cards and waybills and how important they are to operations, but we did not cover something that's even more important to operation. It is staging. Staging is off layout and placed beyond where your layout exists. So let's go over that and find out why that is so important to the operations, especially, as I mumble through that, waybills. You need to understand this to really understand how operation works and waybills and car cards. Oh, and to answer a quick question, people are going, oh, my layout's too small for car cards and waybills. No, the smaller your layout is, the better. In fact, I'll show you my small layout that is gone now, that I definitely started out with car cards and waybills, and it actually makes that layout seem so much larger than it is. Here's a picture of it. As you can see, it's a little layout, but car cards and waybills made that layout seem a lot larger than it is and a lot more fun to operate on. Let's go over staging really quick. Staging is an off-site area where your cars on your layout go. In my case, my layout is between Phoenix and Tucson, which I'm pointing here like you can see that. And my staging represents that part of the area. You can have staging as simple as a barge moved off the layout, or a yard or an interchange with another railroad. You can be a train come by, the CXX train, and it could be your staging area. You just have to have one real staging area. So if you have a branch line, your staging area would be at the far end of your branch line, probably interconnected with another railroad, let's say CSX or Norfolk and Southern or something like that. But you need that to really make your operations actually work and feel larger than it is and believable. There are a few type of layouts that staging is not as important and you don't see it. A lot of the logging style railroads where they're kind of self-contained, like a steel mill. Offsite staging is kind of an iffy kind of thing if it's just you concentrate on the steel mill itself. So it varies and depends if it's concentrated, but really every car that you have on the layout should not go from an industry on the layout to an industry on the layout. It's why would you do that in real life? You'd rather truck it. You need to get it off your layout into staging, maybe a yard. Like in Phoenix, would be Mobest Yard if you want to, if you're Vinny. That could be your off-site staging. But you just have to find some place to go. So let's go over my staging real quick and look at how that works. On my layout, I have two staging points, which is Phoenix up here in the top, which is actually through this tunnel down into the helix. Everything that comes off of staging, which is coming onto the layout, arrives from here. And my lower staging area, which is down here, this is represents Tucson. So everything that rides comes through Tucson comes up here. And we actually travel from here, from Tucson, all the way up to Phoenix. My layout is a bridge route, so it represents the in-between, the Phoenix and the Tucson. I don't know if I actually got you aimed right, but I hope you get the general idea. So let's go look at my staging real quick. So on my layout, this is the main entrance to staging and exit to staging. My staging yard is set up kind of like a beads on a string. Think of it as a string of sausages hooked end to end. So how my staging works is this is my entry track into staging. And as you can see over to that far track right there where my finger is, that represents everything coming into or out of Tucson, which goes into my lower level. And these two tracks here are into the helix. So this is Phoenix. So if you can see, everything will flow down into the staging. And this is the main feed into it. Think of it as like a necklace, as my staging yard is kind of looped around. So it comes down here and will circle back around and exit through the top. The whole lower level is basically a big balloon track. And that's how the staging system works. You see some stagings which are like a muzzle loader where they just end and you got to turn the trains around in between operating sessions. It just depends on how you do it. So as we come in to look at some of my staging tracks here, you can see that all my engines are facing the same direction, leaving staging. So this could be it actually because it's Southern Pacific here, Cotton Belt. This would represent something coming out of Tucson. If we go further down, We got a Santa Fe. This will be coming out of Mobest Yard in Phoenix. You can see they're within the same staging yard body, but because when this leaves a layout, this will come up through the helix and come up through the Phoenix end. When this leaves a layout, or leaves a staging onto the layout, this train will come in through the lower section through Tucson because it represents Southern Pacific, and we got Santa Fe up here. But as you can see, they all come down through the staging yard, through the body, and that right up here is the exit of my staging track. So we looked at the entrance, that's the exit. So at the exit, you have the choice of heading to the Tucson side, if you're Southern Pacific Cotton Belt type of equipment, or you run up through the two tracks that go through the main helix up to the top Phoenix level. So that's basically how the staging yard operates on my layout. There's different ways to do it, but this is how mine works. Let's look and get a better feel of how the staging yard works on my layout. So to understand how my off-site staging works on my layout, I represent all my staging tracks have one of these blue staging cards in them. And the cards help you identify the track, which is, for instance, M235, which is macro code 235, which will switch my tortoises down, M234, M233, M252. And my because the way my track is blown down, think of, like I said, like sausages on a string. So the 200s are this section, 300s are over there, 100s are around the corner, so sausage 100, sausage 200, sausage 300. I hope that makes a little sense for you. So when a train arrives into my staging yard, my cycles, and all these have been flipped, so my cycle cards, actually, we'll look at them right here. They're all set to whatever, and the cycle, don't worry about what the cycle number is, it just helps you go to the next one. You can see that these have already been turned, so these show new areas where these are going to go. But what happens is, and I'll show that with the train will arrive in staging, it will receive a blue flag, which tells me that this train will not move out of staging until I service the train. So it's kind of got a cute little story to go with it. But what it tells me that I need to go through and switch all the waybills on the train to the next cycle or service it so it's prepared to leave staging as a new train. So it can be as simple as removing waybills, adding waybills to the car cards, turning it to the next cycle, whatever's needed to prepare that train for the next operating session. Once I do that, I'll take my blue flag card and I'll flip it over to the class 1 or class 1A green, which means this train is ready to go. I got a little cute little spiel here, but basically what this means is this train has been serviced, the cards have been flipped or replaced, or I should say the waybills have been flipped or replaced, and this train is ready to enter the layout as a new character within the actual operation of the layout. So that's kind of the basic how a staging yard works. You can be some I've seen that are really elaborate. Mine is kind of elaborate, but it's basically helping the train get into the staging yard and changing it into something new so it can come back out and play on the layout. So let's go look at a train that I have ready to enter the staging yard, and we'll actually run that train and we'll service it into the staging yard and see how all this is done. So I'll meet you up over here at Old Pueblo Yard. So this is my train. This is my Tucson transfer. It's going to head down to the yard in Tucson from Old Pueblo Yard where we're located right now. So I've already received my power from South Yard. It's already been brought over for me. And the caboose has already been tacked on to the end from the caboose track over here. I did that before doing this because that's what we're talking about, is the power and that. But what we are talking about is getting this train off the layout to staging, which represents someplace else other than my layout. So in my case, if we look at my car cards, I have my power card, which is gray. It tells me a little bit about the engine. It's 8013. It can be multi-unit consistent, all that kind of good stuff. And the very back card is my caboose card. Usually there's some sort of instructions within the caboose card that you might have to follow on that. This one doesn't have any instructions on it, so it's just a standard caboose and treat it as such. Within my train, I have my car cards, which are represented here with the pockets. We went over that yesterday, and the waybills. So if I go through my train really quick, I will match up each car to its car card and make sure that's correct. So I've already done that. I'm not going to do that for you. But some people like to do what's called a brake check. So what I do is I count my car cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I have 9 car cards, the caboose. So I'll count 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 10 cars, including the caboose, behind my power. So I mean, this train is ready to go. I verified it. I've done my brake checks. I've checked all my numbers. So what we're looking at on my car cards, on my waybills, and we'll just go with this first one, is we know that they're all going to the same destination. So on my case, on my layout, if it says waybill on the top and it's yellow, it represents someplace off the layout. If it's on my layout, it will say something other than waybill. For instance, like Tempe or something like that represents someplace within the layout itself. But if you have that secondary line, so we know this is off layout, this is the staging style card on my layout. You can make them however you want, but this is why I do it. And then it tells me what train it runs out on. So it's going to be on the Southern Pacific Tucson transfer train. So right there, that tells me all the information I need to know. And because my cards are color-coded in a way, I can actually open that up and look and see, oh, I have everything I need to have here. If I opened up one of my car cards and I noticed, and that's all the colors do really, is just help as an operator. I look at my thing and I go, one of these is not like the other. Why do I have a LaGrange car, which is on layout within this group of cars? I have to call up the yard master and go, hey, why is this in my train? It doesn't belong here. The yard master will either remove it or go, oh, that doesn't belong there, you miscounted, or something. So that's basically the purpose of my color coding. It doesn't really mean anything other than a quick visual aid to see what you have in the right spot. So if I had my LaGrange train going up to LaGrange, all the cards would be look like that. They'd say LaGrange on, so we know. Or it might have a blocks of 2 or 3 different areas on it, maybe a LaGrange, a Vermont, and something else. So I could verify everything's blocked correctly. That's all those colors represent. It just makes it easier on the operator. So now that we've verified my train, it really doesn't matter what's in them or where they're really going, because we know that they're from Tortilla Flats on my layout. And this kind of tells where they were and where they're going. The two destinations are all off layout. So what do we got here? We got Charlottesville, Sears and Roebuck, Carthage, Mobile, Alabama. So they're all off layout. They're nothing on my layout. So we know that, and it represents someplace else. I hope this is making sense. I'm kind of rushing through this and rambling. So we got our train, we got our power card, we got our caboose. We have a complete train. We are ready to depart. So we'll start pulling that train out. It's going to head to Tucson, which is staging. So it actually takes what was done in the layout and takes them someplace else to where they can a new train. So what we'll do is, I don't have my apron here, we will get out the old power cab since we're going to use a power cab. It should be already dialed up. Direction forward. We'll fire our headlight on. Our headlight should be on. Because I'm in scale, I don't have any fancy sounds or anything on any of my stuff really. So let's get the headlight on. So we'll depart. We've already got permission from the yard master and all that kind of good stuff, and we have the main. So we'll just pull our train out and we'll head towards Tucson to our staging area. At this point, my train is almost to the end of the layout. We will stop here at the crew change point right here. This represents the division between my layout and Tucson and staging. So we'll stop my train right here at the crew change point, actually before the turn out here. So as an operator, who's ever operating this train is basically done with this train. What he'll do is, we're going to do our crew change, and We'll drop our car cards within the crew change box, so whoever's doing staging will know that this train is ready. You'll notify the person that runs staging, go, there's a train SP8013 to Tucson is ready for a crew change. So that is all you need to do. You are done as an operator with this train. Now we're going to represent the person running staging. So the person running staging will come over, verify the train, they'll pull out their car cards and verify we have an engine, we have the cars match, they're all going to staging like we did before. All you have to do is fan them open, but I prefer them to check car numbers, and we can see everything's going to staging. There should be 10 cars in the train, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, including two booths. So this train is ready to enter staging. So we're representing the crew change. So before I enter changing, I got to do my macro to 252, which does my tortoises. So I'll go macro, 252, enter. And you can hear my tortoises running, so it's aligning everything up. So this will roll down in the staging. So we'll get this rolling in the staging right now. The person running staging will grab the cards and we'll start the train down into that mini helix into staging. So as a person running staging, I'll start my train running into staging. And it's going to run down the little mini helix, as you can see, which will lead in the staging. We'll go catch it before it enters staging on the other side. That's our train now coming out of the lower split helix, and it's going to be entering the outside loop track that represents staging. So now we're basically into the staging area. And we'll follow this track around to where the staging desk is, and then at that point we'll select a staging track for our train. So let's go back where the staging desk is. So we'll prepare the stop up here at the power or the staging desk, which is right there where the racer is. So we'll stop at the staging desk. Now the train has arrived to the staging desk. So what's going to happen now is the person running staging will sit there and use these last numbers on each car card, 6, 5, 6, 6, and he'll add those up. And that will actually give you a number and it'll tell you how long this train will be and what track will fit in. So this number has to be smaller than the staging track that it'll go on. So each staging track has a number, basically a train length, which will tell you how long this train is and whether it'll fit. So let's say we already did that. We have selected staging track M234, which is this staging track right here, because the train will fit within that length. We've already done our math. What we'll do is we'll take a blue flag card, we'll stick it in this train, meaning this train, when it gets to its position, it will need to be serviced. So we'll add that to our stack of car cards. We'll pull up on our train, we will select macro 234, 234, enter, and you should hear stuff run. Oops, did it not go? Select macro 234, enter. And there we go, I just pushed the wrong number. So what it's done is it has lined up all the tracks within my staging yard, so the train will actually arrive on this track. So let's run this train around here and bring it into staging. So I'll actually just leave my cars, instead of carrying them, I'll leave them here at the stage desk. I should take them with me, but we're just going to leave them there just for ease of use. So we'll just follow the train all the way around through the staging yards. And it's on the outside, which is basically the feeder track into the different staging tracks. So when it reaches the end of this balloon track, it's going to actually loop around and come back towards us. At this point, our train has looped around to the far end of the staging balloon track, and we're actually within the staging yard itself. And our train's going to work its way around. We've already selected track 234, so it should travel right in the track 234 and be ready for staging. There it goes. We are now within its staging track. So we'll follow our train all the way to the end of that staging track, 234. Bring it up to where the foul point is, and we'll stop right there. That train is now in position. At this point, we'll take our cards representing our train and our staging track, and we'll drop them into box 234. And that is now complete for the operator, the owner of the layout, to prep them for next operating session. The operating session is over. The guests have gone home. I'm going to start prepping for my next operating session. So I'll come over to my staging tracks and I'll look. I go, this train's already been taken care of. I look over here and I go, on this staging track, this train has not been prepared for next operating session. I see the blue flag. And I, like I said, I just use the blue flag because you're not supposed to move the train versus the green just for ease of use. So I'll go through, take our cards out. I'll go back and I'll verify that all the proper cards are within the train to start with. But basically all that involves is now I'm going to cycle my waybills. So this now will become waybill number 3. Cycle that. So on 4, I'm at 4, I can either completely remove the card and have install a new one in, leave it empty, to go back onto the layout to find a new place, but in this case I'm just going to flip it over and start it over at 1. Same thing with this one, I could actually do it, but just out of ease of use, we'll start it at 1. And this one here is interesting because you'll notice that it's a new off-site staging train, so this will actually go up to the top of the layout, get switched out, and return to the Southern Pacific Phoenix style staging up at Mobest Yard. So that's kind of a neat little thing. So it's a bridge that adds traffic. It doesn't actually do anything on the layout other than fill up a train. So we just keep doing that. Got another one that's a bridge. Bridge. Make that number 3. And I've done, I'll show you how to fill out a waybill later on so you understand what's kind of going on. That's 2, that's 3. As you can see, this one goes to another off staging section on my layout. It goes to Southern Pacific up to 7th Street in Phoenix. Different staging area, still represented by this staging stuff here. And then the final one would be 3 on that one. Another one that runs to Southern Pacific up in Phoenix at 7th Street. And these are pretty much local areas. And number 4, I could either take it out, run the car empty, put a new one in. I don't have any other car cards or waybill, so I'll just start it over at 1. So this train is ready to go back onto the layout for the next operating session. It's been flipped and serviced. I have a lot of stuff going in the tortilla flats. Some off-site staging up through the Phoenix area for both the Santa Fe and the Southern Pacific, and I got one for Hermosa, which is kind of fun because Hermosa's not built yet. I still need to build Hermosa, so that's kind of cool that I have a car going to Hermosa that's not even there. So we'll return our cards in the proper order back into our box for staging track 234. We'll take our card because we've serviced it, flip it over, and now it's a green card, and basically it's telling me that this train is ready to work at the next operating session. Now we're starting our next operating session. I need a train from Tucson to Old Pueblo Yard. So I'll come over to my staging tracks, and I already know where stuff is, but we'll just keep using the same train. So I know that this train, which is Southern Pacific 8013, is ready to go to Tucson. So I looked here, it's already been done, everything's been ready. What I'll do now is, because I'm going to run this train, I'll remove this from the staging card, and I'll return this over to the staging desk. And actually the person running staging will do this, they'll actually prep this train. So I'll put this where it belongs, I'll be right back. So we'll select our car cards at the staging desk, and we will take our train, direction, and we'll run it out of the staging yard and up to the crew interchange point up there at the far end of the basin, which is Oro Junction. And it's now on the return part of the loop. It doesn't need to go through the staging bodies. So we have the inbound loop, the return loop, and the staging body. So we're out of the staging bodies and on the return loop. So at this point, we have to select where our train is actually going. So we have the options of from Tucson, which is macro 1, and this train is from Tucson, or from Phoenix, which is macro 2, which will run this train up through the main helix and end up on the top level. But we're not doing that. We're from Tucson. So we'll select macro 1, enter. And you can hear all the staging tracks lining up. So this train, and now our train out of staging, is prepared to enter the lower helix and go to the crew change point at Oro Junction. We start to see our train arrive out of the split helix from Tucson as we arrive up here at Oro Junction to the crew interchange. We'll stop right before the interchange. As the stage master, we have our train ready for an operator. We'll drop the car cards into the crew change box and we'll call an operator to run this train up to Old Pueblo Yard. As an operator, I was just called. I have a train to pick up, which is Southern Pacific 8013 from Tucson. I'm supposed to meet the train at Oro Junction at the crew interchange point. And I've done that. I've come here and I've looked in my box here at the crew interchange point, or crew change point, and I see that I have my car cards are in the box. I'll grab my car cards, verify my engine, which is SP8013. I'll count my cars in the train, which is brake test, all the way around back, which should be 10 cars, including the caboose. And we will head on up to Old Pueblo Yard. We've just entered yard limits at that glue bottle, so we start to slow down with our train. Hopefully it doesn't run anything on the bench here. And we'll stop right here. And we've contacted the yard master. The yard master said, take the inbound track. So we've set it up. And we will roll our train into track number 1. Normally we'd cut our power and our caboose and let the yard crew take care of that. But for this case, we're just going to roll it right into the yard body track number 1. Because we're not showing how the yard works, we're just showing how the staging yard works. Our run is almost complete. Only thing that's left to do is we have to take our car cards. We'll verify that we have our full train. I can actually look and I can see my caboose is right here, so I know I didn't lose anything. So if I left with the right amount, I should have 10 cars. We'll count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The yard master would take my cards from me and he would drop them into the yard body track number 1. And this train is ready to classify. Granted, the engine would already be removed and put down to South Yard to the shops for service. The caboose should already been removed and put down into the caboose track down there at the far end. But for this demo, we're talking staging. So at this point, this train is ready to be classified during this operating session. I hope this video helps you out on understanding how a staging yard works, or staging tracks, interchange, whatever you want to call it. One of the most important parts of your operating session is actually having off-site places for your train to go. Real trains do not run back and forth in the little area. And just by doing the staging, it will make a real small layout, seem much bigger than it really is. So I hope that helped make a little bit of sense what staging is and how it works. This should be like a primer. This is not, I did this on the fly. So I'll do another video later on. And it'll really explain how staging yards work and all that kind of stuff. But this is just kind of a get to know the staging yards. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below. Ask questions. I do read and answer those questions. Sometimes not right away, but I do get to them within a week or so, depends on what's going on. And if you haven't done already, subscribe down below. And do not forget, I have my Amazon mystery link of the day. Check that out and see what you guys think. I really don't know what I'm thinking about. Probably after I watch the video, I'll decide what that Amazon mystery link of the day is. I hope you guys like that, and I will see your faces tomorrow.